among the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear.
As gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair. A king he was, on carven throne, in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door, the light of sun and star and moon, in shining lamps of crystal hue, and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
their chisel clove and graver wrote,
their forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built.
Their barrel, pearl, and noble bale, and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and corse, light axe and sword, and shining spears were laid in hoard.
Unwearied then were to folk beneath the mountain's music walk.
The harpers harped, the minstrels sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is rung, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in Durin's halls. The shadow lies upon his tomb, immoria in casa tu.
Sunken stars appear in dark and endless Mirrormere.
There lies his crown in water deep, till Durin wakes again from sleep.
the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear.
As gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin. Who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was on carven throne, in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door, the light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue,
and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
their chisel clove and graver wrote,
their forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
their barrel girl and gorgle bale and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and course, that axe and sword, shining spears were laid in war.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music walk.
The harpers harped, the minstrels sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is rung, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in shadow lies upon his tomb. In Moria, in Casa Doom,
but still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless Mirrormere.
There lies his crown in water deep, till Durin wakes again from sleep.
mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was, on carven throne, in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue, and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
the chisel clove and graver wrote, there forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
the barrel girl and gorgle bailed, and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and corse, that axe and sword, shining spears were laid in ward.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music walk.
The harper's heart, the minstrel sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is rung, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in upon his tomb, in Moria, in Casa Doom.
But still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless Mirrormere.
Their lies is crowned in water deep.
Again from sea.
the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondor. He was on carven throne in many pillared halls of stone with golden roof and silver floor and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
the chisel clove and graver wrote, there forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built.
The barrel, pearl, and gobble bale, and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and course, that axe and sword, and shining spears were laid in hoard.
Unwearied then were to
the minstrel sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is thrown, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in. Shadow lies upon his tomb, in Moria, in Casa Doom.
But still the sunken stars appear.
Again from sea.
young, the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was, and carven throne in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue, and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
the chisel clove and graver wrote, there forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
the barrel pearl and noble bale and metal wrought, like fish's mail, buckler and course, that axe and sword, shining spears were laid in hoard.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music walk.
The harpers harped, the minstrels sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is rung, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in shadow lies upon his tomb, in Moria in Casa Doom.
But still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless Mirrormere.
There lies his crown in water deep, till Durin wakes again from sleep.
mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear.
As gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was on carven throne, in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue,
and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
the chisel clove and graver wrote, there forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
the barrel pearl and opal pale, and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and corse, that axe and sword, shining spears were laid in war.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music woke.
The harper's heart, the minstrel sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is rung, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in Durin's halls. The shadow lies upon his tomb, in Moria in Khazad-dûm.
But still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless Mirrormere.
Their lies is crowned water deep, till Durin wakes again from sleep.
Thank you.
the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was on carven throne in many pillared halls of stone with golden roof and silver floor and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue,
and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
the chisel clove and graver wrote.
There forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built.
Their barrel, pearl and noble bale and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and course, that axe and sword and shining spears were laid in. Is crowned in water deep.
young, the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was on carven throne in many pillared halls of stone with golden roof and silver floor and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue,
and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
their chisel clove and graver wrote, their forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
their barrel girl and gobble bale and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and corse, that axe and sword, shining spears were laid in hoard.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music walk.
The harper's harp, the minstrel sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is rung, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in Durin's halls. The shadow lies upon his tomb, in Moria in Khazad-dûm.
But still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless Mirrormere.
Their lies his crown in water deep, till Durin wakes again from sleep.
young, the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere.
Gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondor. He was on carven throne in many pillared halls of stone with golden roof and silver floor and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
their chisel clove and graver wrote, their forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined the mason.
Their barrel pearl and noble pale and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and course that axe and sword and shining spears were laid in board.
Unwearied then were to
the minstrel sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is thrown, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in.
mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas that passed away, the world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was, on carven throne, in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door, the light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue,
and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
the chisel clove and graver wrote, there forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
the barrel girl and noble bale and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and horse, that axe and sword, shining spears were laid in hoard.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music woke.
The harper's harp, the minstrel sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is rung, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in shadow lies upon his tomb, immoria in casa doom.
But still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless Mirrormere.
There lies his crown till Durin wakes again from sleep.
were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argoth throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was, on carven throne, in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door, the light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue,
and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
the chisel clove and graver wrote, the forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
the barrel that axe and sword and shining spears were laid in hoard.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music walk.
The harper's the minstrels sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is thrown, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in upon his tomb, in Moria in Casadum.
But still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless Mirrormere.
There lies his crown in water deep.
the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in Mirrormere and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was on carven throne, in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door, the light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue,
and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
the chisel clove and graver wrote, there forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
the barrel pearl and noble pale and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and course that axe and sword and shining spears were laid in war.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music walk.
The harper's harp, the minstrel sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold, no harp is rung.